When you have hundreds or even thousands of dollars in cryptocurrencies and NFTs, it is extremely important to keep them secure. Keeping your cryptocurrency on an exchange like Coinbase or Binance or Kraken does not mean they're safe. Likewise, keeping your NFTs in your MetaMask wallet also does not mean they're safe and secure. In order to ensure your cryptocurrency and NFTs are safe from hacks and scams, you need a physical wallet. These are sometimes referred to as hardware wallets or cold storage wallets. In this video, I'll be showing you how to set up one of the most popular hardware wallets, the Ledger Nano X. And I'll be showing you how to secure your NFTs and your crypto on the Ledger Nano X so that you can be safe from any scams or any hacks. And by the end of this video, you'll see why investing around $100 in a hardware wallet could potentially save you hundreds or thousands or millions of dollars in the event that you're hacked. I'm Devin Cook, and welcome back to DevMoney. Now, first, a bit of a disclaimer. I'm not being sponsored to make this video. I paid for this Nano X with my own money, and I just want to show it to you guys because I think it's pretty awesome and because I think it's important to secure your crypto and your NFTs so that way you're safe while browsing the internet and no one's gonna steal your money or your NFTs. Now, before we get into the unboxing and all of the how-tos, you're probably asking yourself right now,
do I even need a physical wallet? Is it important enough for me to secure my NFTs or my cryptocurrencies?
Well, the question I would have you ask yourself is, how much money do you have stored on an exchange or on your wallet like MetaMask? If you only have like $100 in cryptocurrencies stored on an exchange or your wallet, it's probably not worth it to you. But if you have spent thousands of dollars, tens of thousands, hundreds, or even millions of dollars on cryptocurrency or NFTs, I would say 100% you need to buy the Ledger Nano, because if your wallet or your exchange is compromised and you lose that money, well, it's gone at that point and you can't do anything about it. But if someone was to try and hack your wallet or hack the exchange that you have your money on, if you have a physical wallet connected and storing your private keys, no one will be able to take your money or your NFTs out of your wallet. So if you have over $1,000, I would say 100% you need to go buy a wallet because it's as cheap as $60. So I would keep that as your benchmark. If you have over $1,000, you need to get a physical wallet. Now, before we get into the unboxing, I'm going to show you which wallet I chose, how much it costs, and why I chose this wallet. Now, when you go to ledger.com, you can see the different products. I bought the Ledger Nano X. I bought it because it's one of the most popular, easy to use, and best rated cryptocurrency and NFT wallets. Another popular option is the Trezor wallet, but I did not buy that wallet. It seemed a bit more expensive for the same thing, and I liked the Ledger better, so I went with that option. If you want to see a comparison between the two, let me know in the comments down below. But back to the Ledger Nano, you're going to see you have different options. You have the Ledger Nano X and the Ledger Nano S. Now, the Ledger Nano X is going to be a bit more expensive than the Ledger Nano S. It's $119 for the Nano X, whereas the Nano S is only $59, I believe. Yep, $59 right there. Now, to show you a comparison between the Nano S and the Nano X is, you see, obviously there's a price difference. The Nano X is twice the price, but it does have a bigger screen, but that's not the main reason I chose it. The main reason I chose it is because it does have Bluetooth, so you don't actually have to physically connect your Nano to your computer every time you want to confirm a transaction, which is what you have to do with this here Nano S. But with the Nano X, it also has more memory. So you can see here that you can secure and manage all of your crypto at the same time. You can install up to 100 apps on the Nano X, whereas you can only install up to 3 apps at the same time on the Nano S. So now this is a big deal for me, because if you want to store Ethereum and Bitcoin and Cardano with the Nano S, you're pretty much already maxed out. But what if you have Solana, or you have XRP, or you have Polkadot, or you have any of the other cryptocurrencies, and there's a ton, Bitcoin Cash, there's tons of different cryptocurrencies. I wanted to have more flexibility in the long run to store more cryptocurrencies, and so that's why I went with the Ledger Nano X. And if you're interested in, or you think in the future you might buy more than just Bitcoin and Ethereum, I would suggest going with the Nano X, because that's going to be more future-proofed and better for the long haul. If you only ever buy Bitcoin, or you only ever have Ethereum, that's all you're going to do and you just know it, go ahead and buy the Ledger Nano S, and it's going to give you the same level of security. The Nano X is just better if you have more cryptocurrencies. So here's the Ledger Nano X. You can see the box that it comes in. It's shrink-wrapped very nicely, and here's the packaging for it. Here's a bit of details about the device on the outside, and now let's get right into opening it up. So once you take off the shrink wrap, you can then slide the box out of this sleeve, and then you can see that you got to take the lid of the box off. And once you take that lid off, you'll see you have your Ledger Nano sitting right there in the box. You can take that off, set it aside, and I'll show you that in a minute. And as you begin to take the box apart some more, you'll see that you have some different paperwork. Obviously, you're gonna have all of your regulatory paperwork, where it just has a bunch of information that I'm pretty sure no one reads about any product that they buy. You're gonna have a USB A to USB Type C cord, so this is what you're gonna use to charge the device, because it is Bluetooth and has a small battery inside. You're gonna get 3 recovery sheets that are all blank, and you can use this to write down your 24-word seed phrase or recovery phrase. You also get another little pamphlet which just has some startup information, tells you how the buttons work. The left button goes left, the right button goes right, and if you press both buttons simultaneously, it will confirm an action. And it also comes with this little cord so that you can attach attach it to your Nano, and you can put it on your key ring or anywhere else that you would like to attach it to. Now, looking at the Ledger Nano, you can see that it folds out like this to protect the actual device. It looks like this is made out of aluminum, and you can see the buttons on the left and on the right. It's protected by a little film to protect the screen. And then you can see here the USB-C port that you're gonna use to charge it. Now, Ledger recommends that you charge the device when you first get it, so I'm gonna plug it in, and you're gonna see that the Ledger Nano immediately starts up. Now, I'm gonna be using the Ledger Live app on my iPhone to set up this device. And you can see me going through this process. What I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to pair the device, and I'm also gonna have to set a pin. And one of the first steps to set up the device is you need to make a pin for the device. This is gonna be the pin that you use to turn on the device and also to confirm any actions when you're sending NFTs or when you're sending cryptocurrency. So set up your pin, make sure it's a strong one, make sure it's not one that you just use on your iPhone or anything like that. Make sure it's a brand new pin that you've just come up with and that you will remember. And the next thing it's gonna do is give you your secret recovery phrase. Now, it's gonna give you the secret recovery phrase in the form of 24 unique and random words. And it's gonna start showing you these words one by one. You can scroll through by pressing the left or the right buttons on your Nano, and you need to write all of these words down in the correct order. And they're all lowercase, so you don't need to worry about being case sensitive when you're writing down the phrase. Now, once you've written down all 24 words of your seed phrase, it's then gonna ask you to confirm your seed phrase. And so what you're gonna have to do is it's now gonna show you all of the words one by one, and you're gonna have to scroll through. And once you've found your first word, you're gonna have to confirm it by pressing the left and right buttons simultaneously. And then you're gonna have to go to the second word. Refer to your sheet of paper that you wrote all these down and continue through all 24 words. Now, once you have confirmed your recovery phrase on the Nano, the app on your iPhone or your Android will give you a quick little 3-question quiz that you can answer. So that way you understand some basic information about how the Nano works. Essentially, no, your cryptocurrency is not being stored on the blockchain. Just your private keys are being stored on the blockchain, and you should not give your recovery phrase or your seed phrase to anybody, not even Ledger themselves. It is important to note, if you do lose your Ledger Nano and you have to buy another one, you can use the seed phrase or this recovery phrase to set up the new Nano. That's the only time you'll be putting it in onto another Ledger device, is if you lost one, it was destroyed or stolen, and you need to set up a new device. That's the only time you're gonna need to input that phrase. Okay, now you're gonna need to pair your Nano to your iPhone or your Android. So in order to do that, you just hit pair, you follow the on-screen guides. It's gonna ask you to confirm that you see the right code on your iPhone as well as on your Nano. You just hit yes on your iPhone, and you just press left and right buttons at the same time on your Nano to confirm that. And once the devices have been paired, your phone is gonna authenticate the Nano. Basically, it's gonna make sure it's a genuine Ledger Nano and that it's not been tampered with, that the software is all intact and it's not been compromised in any way. Once you're through with that process, you're gonna then be able to install apps on your Nano. So you're just gonna scroll through and find whatever app you want to install. For this case, I'm gonna show you how to do this with NFTs. And so I'm gonna download the Ethereum app. If you have Dogecoin, Cardano, Bitcoin, or any other coin, you can download those apps and store the private keys on your Ledger Nano. Now, it does take a minute to install, but once it does, we can go to the next step, which is to connect your hardware wallet, your Ledger Nano, to your MetaMask wallet or whatever other wallet that you use, but I'm using MetaMask. So now that you've set up your Ledger, you'll need to go onto your computer and go to your MetaMask wallet or any other wallet that you're gonna connect your Ledger to. So in this case, MetaMask. So I go in here to my MetaMask wallet. You can see some Ethereum, some DAI. You can see all the stuff I have in here. So in MetaMask, when you log in, you will see that you don't have your NFTs there, even if you've created a test NFT or if you've bought other NFTs. You will see them on the mobile app, but on the desktop app, if you want to see them, you have to import them directly. So you can go over to your NFT, and then you need to go down here to details, click on the contract address. It's gonna take you to Etherscan, and then you're gonna go here to the token tracker, click on that, and then click on more and add token to MetaMask. Well, what you're gonna do in order to connect your wallet is you're gonna go to your profile photo, hit connect hardware wallet. Yes, we have a Ledger, so we'll click this one. You do need to download the app, and you need to connect your Ledger. So hit continue, open Ledger Live, because I've downloaded this app on the computer already. So then you'll get your Ledger, and in order to connect it, you'll need to put in your PIN. Now you hit get started on the Ledger Live on the desktop, enter Ledger, here's the device. Now on the Ledger desktop app, since we already have it set up, we can just hit connect your Nano X. So we're gonna hit check the Nano right here, connect and unlock your device. So what you'll do is you'll plug in your Ledger into the USB cord and then plug that into your computer. All right, so once we've unlocked our device, we're gonna allow a Ledger Manner on your device. So we'll double tap on our Ledger on both things. All good, your Ledger is genuine and ready to use. So now we'll click add account, choose our crypto asset, Ethereum, continue, add accounts. It's gonna think, it's gonna think, it's gonna think. Open the Ethereum app on your device. Double press both buttons right there. It's synchronizing, synchronizing. It's gonna basically just do this whole thing for a while. All right, and then you're just gonna hit add account. You can rename it if you want, but I don't want to. Boom, here we go. Now once it's set up on your desktop, you're gonna get this notification asking if you want to expose your device. Yes, we're gonna have to expose our device because that's what's gonna connect it to MetaMask. Okay, so we connected this MetaMask bridge. You can now access your Ethereum account on a third-party application authentication through WebSocket. Perfect. Now, one thing that's important to note is once you've set up an account on your Ledger Live app, you're gonna need to hit the receive button and you're gonna get this screen right here, hit continue. All right, so then it's gonna give you an address right here. You're gonna need to copy that address or at least remember the first couple letters and numbers of the address and the ending of the address, because then you're gonna head into your MetaMask and then you're gonna see the first one is probably gonna be that address that you just got from your Ledger Live. So you hit unlock right there and boom. And now you have a new wallet called the Ledger One. And this is gonna be your hardware MetaMask wallet. So you're gonna wanna transfer all of your crypto and everything you have into this wallet right here. And then if you ever wanna transfer something out by hitting send, you're gonna have to confirm that on your Ledger Nano by putting in your PIN code and approving the transaction. And so what this is essentially gonna do is keep anyone from hacking in and just sending all of your money and all of your tokens places, because they'll have to confirm it on the physical wallet. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.